Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I'll find out starting in today's game between the Colgate Raiders and the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
Points of emphasis, Dick. What do you got for us?
First off, they should be looking for second chance opportunities by going to the offensive glass. Putbacks are a great way to get some easy baskets. Secondly, they must get on their wing players and post players to run the floor. If they do so, their point guard will then be able to make the hit-ahead pass. Lastly, encourage your players to be overly aggressive at the defensive end. Really look for the steal or the trap.
And it's time for the tip-off. The Razorbacks whip the tip, and they spring into striking distance. The shooting guard takes the feed. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And up. But he missed the shot. The point guard handles the feed. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the dribble, gives it up. He's got to get rid of it. Great defense, forcing a call of 5 seconds. Teams will play all sorts of tempos and styles these days, Dick. What are some of the characteristics of up-tempo teams?
They sure are. They like to recruit athletes, namely guys who can get out and run, fill the lanes, and pressure opponents. Dump it inside.
He's all alone. Number 13 buries the three-pointer. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
Chance for an easy one.
Look at the highlight, NBN.
He gets it to go. A great trap initiated by the defense. Passes it out of the trap from left of the circle and come up short. Pushes it up. For the bucket, perfectly executed. The shooting guard gets the pass. That's a great defensive effort being all over the ball. They get the 5 second call. Picked off. Gave it up. The Raiders with the push. Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Stolen away. Pushes it up. Tries for two. Up and in. The small forward takes the feed.
Oh, what a high rise, a great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
work it back to the outside. Ten on the shot clock. For two, the lay-in.
What are some of the things that up-tempo teams will look to do, Dick?
One thing which stands out in my mind is the type of defense they play. Often up-tempo teams press, trap, and disrupt the offense at every chance they get.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Coach has been very animated over here on the sidelines. His team is doing a great job of following strategy and playing that up-tempo style. I'm sure he'll continue to encourage them over the course of the game to ensure they don't stray away from what's working.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. The small forward receives the ball, kicks it out. There's the rejection. He misses from way outside. A little two-man action. Kicks it out.
High post screen, gonna use it.
Goes up for two. Gave it up. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. On the dribble, gives it up. Got to give that 5-second call to the defense. Ball's coming from the sideline. Down inside. There's a bad pass right to the defender.
Look at speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
The ball goes out of play. Number 44 gets his first minute.
Very strategic substitution, Brad. Good decision by the coach.
Controlling the ball.
Great anticipation defensively.
The power forward with the ball. Moving it around the perimeter. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Tries for two, up and in. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. But if that's your philosophy, so be it.
With a deep shot from outside. Off target. Gave it up. Number three steals the ball. Fast break possibility coming.
Good drive right there. Good penetration.
Well, whose team tempo went out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Trying to pack it inside for two. Perfectly executed.
looking for a good shot. For the bucket. The lane. On the outside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Up and in.
If substitutions aren't made in the near future, I can guarantee you that there will be some missed shots and silly mistakes.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job by the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
They work it around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The lay-in.
Frustration right there.
Here they go into the break. Perfectly executed. The small forward gets the ball. They work the perimeter. They get an open three. He gets the shot to fall. One thing I've noticed about up-tempo teams is the manner in which they rebound, Dick.
Up-tempo teams are all about speed and athleticism. Players who can play up-tempo and maintain a high skill level are unique and highly sought after.
The shooting guard takes the pass. They are red hot from behind the arc, Dick.
They're rolling on all cylinders right now.
He can't get any more open than that. Number 22 buries the tray. And a momentary look from three-point land. Pass on the post, turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, passing to the block.
Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. Goes up. He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Anytime now, boys.
They work it around the perimeter. He's in the clear.
Excellent jump shot right there. Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish a good tempo.
Number 15 takes the pass. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Number 34 receives the ball.
Look at that spacing.
For two. Doesn't go. Number 22 takes the feed. Gave it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Pushes it up.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Thanks, Erin. Erin Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there. On the dribble, gives it up. Takes the jumper. Off the mark. Gave it up.
Brad, that young man is really skilled. He can play with his back to the basket or by facing up in the post. It makes him very difficult to stop. He's got great balance inside and outside.
Goes right through the trap.
He wasn't afraid of that trap.
Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. And if that's your philosophy, so be it.
Number 13 with the ball.
Up and inside. There's the screen up on top. They're having a rough time getting them to drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Way off target. They'll take a timeout right here. Well, Dick, execution coming out of a timeout is really important, wouldn't you say?
Definitely, Brad. The play you call or defense you decide to run coming out of a timeout could make or break you. Good coaches will always ensure that their teams are clear on the expectations coming out of a timeout.
Number 40 handles the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Jumper. The two ball's good. Goes up for two. Number 21 is called for the foul. Second team foul.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first. Got him both.
Oh, he drained it. That's him a nylon, MBN.
Traps in place, Dick.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
The small forward with the ball.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Turnaround jumper. He takes the rebound. Number 12 takes the pass. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
The power forward gets the pass.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Point guard handles the feed. Working it around the perimeter. Eludes the trap there. Takes his jumper. Sticks the deuce. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two, off the rim and no good. They're working around the arc. He looks for three. Not there. Number 33 takes the pass. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
On the outside. Refs call the foul the other way.
That's how you take a charge, baby. Escape the trap.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. Steals a pass. The shooting guard takes the feed. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He's got a nice shot fake for two and off the mark. Gave it up. The dribble gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats it to the spot.
The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Number 41 handles the pass. And he'll kick it back outside.
Dump it inside.
He takes the open jumper. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. Great pass out of the trap, Rod.
Dumps it in. At the horn. Number three drills a three. At the half, the Raiders are down by 12. It's been a tight one thus far, Mr. Vitale. What play do you think set the tone here tonight?
Watch this kid elevate, Mr. Nestler. This is easily my highlight of the half. It was a spectacular dunk by the youngster.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Arkansas is shooting very well from the floor right now, Dick.
They're getting good looks, man, and they're not letting them go to waste. That's how you win games, man. Offensive execution.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. The small forward gets the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. 10 seconds on the clock. Moving it around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Passes it out of the trap, trying to feed inside. Great defense. Tries for two. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there and let him think about it for a while.
Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Makes the first shot. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Second one is no good. Looking for a good shot. He unloads. Missed it. Number 22 gets the pass. On the outside. For two. Whistled for the foul. Steps to the line for an easy one. Gets his first. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
He misses it. The shooting guard takes the feed. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He could not get more wide open. Gave it up. For the with a sensational block. The layup.
Instead of giving him that, use a foul.
Balance teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
Brad, they like to balance the top. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think the style works for them.
They're working around the perimeter. 10 seconds to get a shot off. Eludes the trap there. Good for two. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
They work the perimeter. 10 seconds on the clock. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He grabs the board. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. The shot's off target. On the dribble, gives it up. Second count winding down for the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The shooting guard receives the pass, dumps it in.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
And momentary look from three-point land from downtown. He nails the shot. They work it around the perimeter. Blocked. Gave it up. He takes the open jumper. He misses the J.
Look at that spacing.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that. Dump it inside.
Here comes the ball screen. Had to go up high with a shot. Trouble and makes a pass out. Picks off the lazy pass. On the dribble, gives it up. with the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
As we continue to track the game's tempo.
It's definitely been a slower paced game, Rob. Very few opportunities to push the ball.
Gave it up. He goes for three. Drains it. Jumped in front to take it away. The Raiders are on the run. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Tim.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
He's money with a shot. The shooting guard takes the feed. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The shot won't fall. Number one gets the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented blocks like they have.
Yeah, it helps. He couldn't get it to fall. On the dribble, gives it up. For two, number 15 is called for the defensive foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron. Wide, short, long, doesn't matter, doesn't go. Makes his second shot. The small forward handles the feed. Eludes the trap there. Number 23 had a chance to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, good second effort to stay with the right there. Did a great job attacking the defense.
Number 22 to the line for one. He got it. The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick.
Hey, dodge one there, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two. Can't get the shot to go. The shooting guard gets the pass. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
So let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
Gave it up. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, you spin back the other way.
For the deuce, lays it up. Number 34 handles the feed for the bucket, up and in.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
They get an open look for three. Oh, yes. Goes up for two. The layup. trying to feed the low block. Picks off the pass. The shooting guard with the ball. Cross court. Seconds remaining on the shot clock. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He cleans the glass. Goes up for two. Up and in. Working it around the perimeter. Seconds to get it off. Tries for two. The lay-in. Takes away the pass. Looking for a good shot.
Nice high post screen.
He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
The Raiders are going to have to make a move here and make a move fast. Playing in the half court is no longer an option, Dick. They've got to get some quick scores.
Hey, Brad, they have to increase the tempo and start pressing. Basically, do the things they aren't used to doing. Their backs are against the wall.
Kicks it out. He launches a three. Off the mark with a shot. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game. Richard?
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Player fatigue seems to have set in here, Dick. He pump fakes for two. Goes in. Take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
They'll work it around the arc. Ten on the shot clock. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
For the bucket. He gets it to fall. On the dribble, gives it up. Robs him of the ball. Tries for two. The layup is good. On the outside. For two. He missed. Pushes it up.
That little trap really well there, Brad.
Now trying to feed the low block. Ten seconds to put up a shot. Dumps it in. Now the turnaround jumper. Brings it down.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the deuce. Was that beautiful or what? Number picks off the lazy pass. The center receives the ball. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He buries it.
Dump it inside.
Seconds on the shot clock. Goes up for two, and he can't hit the shot. Pushes it up for the bucket with a layup. The shooting guard with the ball. You can't get away with that.
Teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Second one, good. Nick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
The small forward receives the pass. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Hey, currently the tempo is definitely on the high side, Brad.
Eludes the trap there. The ball goes out of bounds. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, and their timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Gave it up. Tries for two. Up for the lay-in. Now they work it around the perimeter. For two. Up and in. They've got this defense in a panic.
Hey, you can't stop what you can't catch.
On the dribble, gives it up. He intercepts it, pushes it. For the deuce, the lay-in. Can't elude the trap.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. 10 seconds to get it off.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
The small forward gets the pass. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Picked off. The Raiders looking to attack in transition. For the bucket. He hacked him. A chance for two. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Gets his second. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. The point guard takes the feed. Kicks it out. Ten on the shot clock. He buries the shot. Pushes it up. He takes the wide open shot. He nails the trifecta. Pushes it. And he'll kick it back outside. Looking for a good shot. He's all alone. He drains the long range bomb.
You can see on the replay how this one goes down.
The small forward takes the feed. The ball goes out of play. This game is not over, Dick, and I mean not by a long shot.
Absolutely not, Brad. I think the momentum actually shifted on that play.
Shot clock is dead. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. This moment is brought to you by State Farm. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
Step to the line for the free throw. He can't get one to fall. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Hey, Brad, that doesn't surprise me. The pace has been quite hectic.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Calling the shots from the sidelines, Dick, is definitely not an easy gig.
I'll tell you, Brad, that's one of the reasons why I got out of coaching. There's so many highs and lows, and man, you got to be able to handle it physically, mentally, and you do this over a 30-game season. It's not an easy gig, baby, but it pays well.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
He can't buy one.
Timeout charge. Hey, can we get a drum roll, Mr. Nestler? This one's going down to the last ticks, baby.
Start things up again. Go back in front by two. On the outside. This is the big time. Misses from long range. Well, Richard, why don't you recap our points of emphasis?
Brad, a good game plan is important. The points of emphasis are a great guide in helping teams focus on the key components. Components which will help a team get that done.
You've got to know your style and play within it. It's such an important part of the game. Quite a few gems in tonight's matchup, but none shone brighter than this one. Tonight's Pontiac game-changing performance. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Arkansas is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.